Right now, when we're looking into the market, I see three circles, three arenas where we see a lot of change. I could go on about this for hours, but I'll try and take the top peaks of this. If we look into the market, we have growth in construction. It's a global phenomenon, and we're growing in most countries. It's like 12 to 15% of the gross national product. That's a huge sector. It's big, and it's growing fast. We need more built stuff. The other thing that's happening is that the product's changing. And whereas the industry is still pretty much the way it looked 25 years ago when I graduated, the products are much different. I come from Denmark. We have some amazing architects there that draw some crazy houses that are very hard to put together. So if you work with big architects one day and you're trying to put a data center together for the food company another day, you kind of see that this is a different ballgame than what we were trying to put together just 5-10 years ago. So that's happening. At the same time, the technology is changing. I don't need to show you the rapid, the exponential growth and all that stuff. But one of the things that's actually happening, I was just in CES in Las Vegas, that there's technology coming out that we don't need yet, that we're not ready for. And we have always been a little bit behind on technology, but we've always been, oh yeah, this technology we can use to solve this problem. At CES, they were talking about 5G, quantum computers, broad AI, stuff that blockchains, stuff that most people still don't comprehend just the concept of, and it's coming out commercially over the next 2 years. And it's going to destroy a lot of things, and it's going to give us a ton of opportunities. So it's coming out really fast, and what's really interesting is it's really cheap. You can get really, really cool stuff very, very cheap over the next couple of years. So the third circle, that's the third arena that we're fighting in, is the organizational one, I call it. So two things I want to top off on that. One is the capacity issue that you also mentioned. It's fewer people for construction. It's not just a matter of that we have fewer laborers, but they also want to be laborers for a shorter period of time. So the guys that I worked with 25 years ago, none of them are carpenters anymore. They have small businesses, or they work in a bird shop or something like that. But unlike their fathers, they're not going to be towing wood and punching nails until they're 70 years old. It's not going to happen. And also, the younger ones, they want an education to be a carpenter. So it's higher education, shorter span, and there's fewer of them. So the capacity that we have is changing. You combine that with growth, that is for anybody of you who just took basic class in economics, that's a horrible scenario. We have nobody to do it and we need more of it. Secondly, with organizations, the construction companies are changing. A contractor is no longer just a contractor. If you look to Scandinavia, where I'm from, you can see that the engineering companies, who call themselves consultants, also buying architect companies, are buying project managers, and are buying IT companies. You can see that the contractors are beginning to do project development, the architects are beginning to do contracting, and the suppliers are sneakily, I'm looking at one of them now, sneakily moving up the value chain, trying to be better friends with the clients and tell them, just give me the job and I'll make sure that at least what I supply to you will work. So the gameplay is changing. We will still be trained as architects and engineers and whatever, but we will no longer work in silos in